Blessed be God, Creator, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal? Says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel? My way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers and sisters, I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were enticed and led astray to idols that could not speak. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one speaking by the Spirit of God ever says, "Let Jesus be cursed." And no one can say, "Jesus is Lord," except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All of these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we are all made to drink of one Spirit. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
After Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came, took her by the hand, and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening, at sundown, the demons and the whole city was gathered around the door, and he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons, and he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, Jesus got up, went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed, and Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to Jesus, "Everyone is searching for you." Jesus answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
of the animating love that flows in and through and among us, Creator, Son, and Spirit. Amen. There are so many reasons to be grateful to be part of a community like St. Paul's, and not just because someone like Sarah Weaver will hand you the bulletin when the gospel is not marked in the gospel book. Today's annual meeting will be full of a sense of humor, just as is this good congregation. And the annual report is bursting forth with joy. There are so many pictures of so many of your faces, and I tell you, it was such a delight to be compiling and putting that together and reflecting on the year that has been passed. Thank you to all of the ministry teams and leaders and individuals who sent your reflections and your photography and stopped by the office this week to check on us and make sure things were proceeding apace. It has been a gift and a grace to be together in this place this past year. Yes, we have been awash in the abundant life of love into which we have been baptized, and today the weather even is reminding us of our baptism. And pretty soon we will be nourished by the gifts that are multiplied around this holy table as we are drawn together in the love of Christ week by week. Here, we discover how the body of Christ can be this amazing community of healing that shares God's grace, mercy, and peace, not just here as we gather with one another, but everywhere we go in our wider world. Today's gospel, the one that was hiding in plain sight in that gospel book, shows us how deeply our lives and our world can be transformed by that sacred food on our journey, nourishing and strengthening, enlivening and connecting us. I am convinced that this story was unfolding in Jesus' life that he was sharing with his friends because he knew that they needed to know that healing was for everyone, not just Simon Peter's mother-in-law. It was for the disciples, it was for Jesus, it was for everyone that was gathered at that table as she rose up from being ill and was strengthened to exercise her gifts for ministry. And yes, it is common in community. We can get so busy being about the work of God that sometimes we don't even notice those communal gifts that are just tucked away in plain sight. And yes, the woman who was healed had tremendous, gracious gifts to share, cooking and hosting, gifts that were obscured as she lay there suffering with her illness. Healed by Jesus, she was empowered to share those gifts freely and joyfully. But I think there was a second reason that this story is here for us, just as it was unfolding in the lives of Jesus' friends. It's an opportunity to notice our habits. Habits that sweep us into all the important and essential work that we are doing in the name of love. Habits that can sometimes accelerate a bit and turn a little frantic as we see just how many people are coming to tap in to what is that amazing expression of love. Yes, it said the whole town was turning out, people in droves, all clamoring for healing. And they needed to discover. Jesus was good at practicing this, but the disciples not so much. They're not usually with him up on those mountains and in those gardens, and if they are, they're falling asleep. But usually they're going, Jesus, where are you? There's people. This throng is gonna just overwhelm us. And he wanted them to learn that sacred practice of holy pause. I'm in that learning curve with them. I don't know about you. Pause that makes room for God in prayer, in silence, in stillness, in waiting, for the Spirit to reveal priorities. rooted in God's dreams for the future, for us and for our world. That was why Jesus went so early to pray on that mountain. At St. Paul's, we too are learning to pay attention to our pace and priorities in this season of our life together. And we are leaning into that practice with prayerful intention and care. You'll hear more about that next week when you come back for our Shrove Sunday celebration and getting ready for the season of Lent, a whole season that's built for this spaciousness of listening and being present with God, and how God is always present in our lives, even when we don't always see it. But today, we are celebrating how creative our community has been in the past year. Our senior warden is often fond of saying that St. Paul's punches above its weight, and he is absolutely right. We have so many exquisite and different and amazing opportunities to lean into this love of God that invites us to grow together. So you're going to see that in the annual report, along with lots of your shining faces, amazing faces, gloriously laid out and designed by, she's not in the room right now, so I can talk about this. When you see Jocelyn, you just shower praise on her. Her creative genius is behind how this report came together, as well as the detailed and beautiful expressions of perspective that came from each and every one of you ministry teams, from Dr. Matthews and members of our vestry, and it's been breathtaking. So you're gonna see in this amazing piece of literature that is so big and expansive that it couldn't be stapled in one booklet form, so you get three, they're like matryoshka dolls. There's an intentional structure that you might miss if you're paying attention to all the papers flipping around. A structure that lifts up how our life together does interconnect. Our ministry teams, our volunteers, our staff, our leaders, all of us rooted in this sacramental life that we share through baptism and Eucharist, these two grounding forces in our life of love in the body of Christ. And these sacraments, entrusted to the church, have the power to shape our lives and to shape our impact as we dare to use our gifts to make a difference in the world. And today, we give thanks for all of the faithful efforts of all who make this life possible, not just the ones who are in the photographs, but the ones who are so busy doing the work of ministry that they're never around to be photographed. Yes, those folks, they come first in the book under the category of strengthening, those people who lift up our spirits and send us out into the world each year by making this worship experience possible. And then there are those who help us deepen our faith, inviting us into spaces where we can wrestle with questions, where God is with us, how we're learning to turn toward God's presence, the things in our world that draw us deeper into this life of love. That's the deepening section, sort of in the zone of formation. You might have heard that category before. And then there's the enlivening component of this life together that we share, where our energies are stirred up and catalyzed and sparking in new ways because of multi-generational and multicultural opportunities for us to grow together by serving and learning alongside one another, especially our next generation of children and youth at St. Paul's. And we have been having more of them coming to be among us since the pandemic. And if you haven't gotten to know them, I hope that you will take time in the coming year to grow in friendship with them. They're amazing people, these families who are here. Last but not least, sort of the foundation of how this all comes together is the connecting section. These are the folks at St. Paul's who help make it possible for us to find one another, to clump together, to experience the joys of shared passions and shared service projects, things that make up the fabric of our community that happen in the backdrop, leaders and finance commission and all vestry, all the people who take time to see where the community needs nurturing, and they turn up in that place with their time and their care and their love. More than anything, As you look at this report and as you listen to the reports that will be given in Foot Hall, I hope you hear in all of this an invitation to take a next step, whether you've been here for decades or a mere few days. Because God wants to bring new things to birth here. And we cannot be that one body alive in the one spirit that Lisa read for us from 1 Corinthians. We can't be that beautiful picture of all the gifts animated for the common good without your participation too. This, after all, is how God designed community from the very beginning. So if you're listening, and I hope you will hear in what is shared in Foot Hall and in the written report, the ways that our growing invites your belonging and your participation. Because like any human body that is evolving, and our cells are constantly being regenerated in our bodies, there are joys and delights for us to share. And there are also these aches and pains as we are sprouting up, just like little ones who feel those aches in their bodies as they grow. Maybe your gifts are meant to help shine the light of love in spaces with our little ones through teaching or mentoring. Maybe your family's ebullient love is a gift that you might share, taking it to someone who is no longer physically able to come to church when we make seasonal deliveries throughout the year. Maybe you feel able and willing to invite someone to join you for one of the two evensong services that will happen in Lent, or Tai Chi on Wednesdays. Whatever it is that is your gift to share with someone who's not yet here, who longs to know God's love, these are the ways that we stretch into and enjoy all that has been percolating and flowing in this communal body this past year. The Spirit continues to call, asking us to use our gifts and their difference-making power in our world. So as we enter the season of holy pause and prioritize places where we can pray, know that your gift matters in this place. I want to share with you three examples of the gifts that have been shared that I've been personally blessed with in the beauty and grace of this one body that we share here at St. Paul's. There's a lot more as the day unfolds, but these three have been especially precious to me. A couple weeks ago, I heard someone share in a small group about her experience of seeing God here at St. Paul's, and she cited something that was this beautiful connective tissue kind of moment where a family whose child was going through cancer treatments had asked for the community to pray. And it meant so much to her to be standing alongside them and journeying with them through the uncertainty and the unknowing and the longing for healing and hope. And knowing that that child is now flourishing and healthy just made this woman shine with her witness to God's healing grace alive at St. Paul's. Another was a date that I had over coffee with two people who are deepening their passion to connect with and learn from the people in our wider community that are paying attention to housing insecurity that many of our neighbors are experiencing. These are folks who want to share their curiosity here at St. Paul's as an invitation to help us grow as we learn together about what is lively in our community. I was blown away by that generosity that they want to bring and stir up to enliven our body. And then finally, in a Eucharistic visit this week, which I don't know how I scheduled that during the week of getting ready for annual meeting, but it turned out to be exactly what I needed. The Holy Spirit knew. I turned up, and this individual, I thought I was coming, you know, to bring communion, bread and wine, the love of St. Paul's. This person blew me away. I was floored. There were multiple hugs, there was humor, there were stories where we learned we both lived in the same place in Alvedon Valley in San Jose. This person also had lived in Boulder, Colorado, and you know, I was 11 years in Denver. It was just this crazy, amazing resonance. And then at the very end, in the most gentle and kind way, this individual reflected a little bit of the light of love
on some spaces in my life that God is still working on. This isn't a first encounter, someone I'd actually been waiting a whole year to get to see. I was blown away by the love and the care that was flowing in that interaction. Y'all, we are one body, sharing one another's joys and pains and this healing journey that is ours because of the love that draws us here. We are baptized into one spirit that animates diverse gifts to nourish this body, deepening connections here that are rooted from a shared life of faith. We are entrusted gifts for healing, and reflecting back that mirror of love that reveals God's hidden blessings, ones that we can notice and nurture in this place, holy gifts that multiplied and shared make every bit of difference. In this body of Christ, love is ever evolving, ever multiplying. So at today's meeting, let's celebrate and recommit to taking our place, sharing the love and the energy and the life, that abundant life that this body of Christ has given us a chance to share together. Amen. Standing as we are able, let us confess the mystery of faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, she is worshipped and glorified. She has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace, we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression.
For all who have requested the prayers of the St. Paul's community, and all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble, especially those affected by the violence in Israel and Palestine.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we remember the Anglican Church of South America. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we remember True Sunshine, San Francisco, Sea Church, San Bruno, and South San Francisco. We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Mark, our bishop, Austin, our bishop coadjutor elect, and for all ministers of the gospel, for peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
We thank you, God, for all the blessings of this life, especially this life we share together at St. Paul's. As we reflect with wonder and joy on all you have revealed among us in the past year, strengthen us with the power of your Spirit to welcome your dreams for our future.
Deepen our creativity and courage to follow Jesus everywhere we love and serve in God's name.
We pray for all who have died, especially Meita Kilimsimasi, Marge Harger, and Sayalosi Tukaafu, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them
who put their trust in you.
Let us join in saying together our prayer for mission.
Gracious and loving God, help us this day to understand and celebrate your dream for the world, to be transformed in Jesus' love, and to use our gifts to make a difference for others. Amen. Praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored. May God grant us the grace to glorify Christ in our own day. Amen. The proof of God's amazing love is this: while we were sinners, Christ died for us. Therefore, let us approach the throne of grace with boldness, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Dear friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share with one another peace, but also we have lots of peace and fun in this foot hall in a moment. Good morning. Welcome to St. Paul's. I'm Sarah. If this is your first day here, we do not usually have an annual meeting. This is a once-a-year festivity, so we're grateful you're here. I'm going to keep the announcements very brief, but we do have some from the community that we do not want to give short shrift. So, Brian, would you like to come? You want to come next Sunday. That's what I want to pregame.
Good morning. So next week, we will have a tradition that's been going on for a few years at St. Paul's. We call it Shrove Sunday, but it's a pancake breakfast to have a feast and prepare for the Lenten season. So I want to invite everyone, come on down, get some pancakes, some breakfast foods. As a special treat this year, we will be highlighting some of the work we do in our local and international communities through the outreach ministries, so opportunity to nourish the body and nourish the soul. Hope to see you there. Thanks.
Thank you, Brian. Susan?
Good morning. I'm Susan Group from the Circle at St. Paul's. We'd like to call your attention, please, to our rummage drop-off coming up this Saturday, February 10th, 10 o'clock in the morning till 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Drive your car into the Occidental parking lot. Our volunteers will unload your car for you and give you a donation receipt. And the Circle wishes to thank the congregation for their generosity and participation.
Thank you, Susan.
If you are new at St. Paul's, we'd love for you to fill out a welcome card when you feel like the time is right. It gives us a chance to get to know you better. And today, you are warmly welcome, each and every one of us, gathered around God's table of love. There is real wine in the cup. You can take a sip from the chalice when it comes by. If you prefer not to receive, cross your arms over your chest. We do have gluten-free wafers if you would like and need that. And know that all of us are drawn together in this love, that we might be filled and nourished and sent forth into our lives with greater peace and joy. So we look forward to sharing this life with you. Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice for the whole world.
Oh,
is right and good and joyful, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. For you are the source of life and light. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious God, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself.
And when we have fallen into sin,
become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ,
your only and eternal Son,
to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, God, Maker of all. Jesus stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance." After supper, Jesus took the wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ
will come again. The memorial of our redemption, Almighty God, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling Christ's life, death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in Christ. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through Jesus Christ, our Savior, by Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
table is ready, so come. You who have much faith and you would like to have more, you who have been here often,
and you who have not been for a long time,
you who have tried to follow Jesus and you who have failed, come, because it is Christ who invites us to meet God.
Thank you.
post-communion prayer is found on page 9 of our service leaflet. Standing as we are able, let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. There will be additional nourishment, including protein-related items, and childcare is available, so I hope to see you in the annual meeting. And now, as we go forth, God's blessing be with you, Christ's peace surround you, the Spirit's outpouring be upon you now and always. Amen.